Those first days in Salieri's bar were slow. I moved crates and delivered messages. The guys busted balls and told stories from the old country. Mostly, we just waited. I got to thinking, maybe life in Salieri's crew wasn't gonna get me clipped.
Come on!
But what did I know?
Finish it off!
You, Tommy?
Come on, there's still gas in your tank! Get it back!
Boss is waiting for you.
Thanks.
Ignora quell'idiota! Arrenditi! Ah, potrai combattere ancora!
There he is.
Sorry I'm late.
Take a seat. And it's collection day, boys. So Tommy, you'll drive. Paulie and Sam can handle the rest. It'll be routine.
Just a handful of stops today.
Bill at the motel was a little short last month. So make sure he pays us the interest he owes.
No problem, boss.
Don't lay hands on anyone unless there's no other choice. Our clients need to understand that we provide a valuable service. They need to look at you and see Santa Michael. They need to believe you'll protect them.
So let Morella stoop to breaking legs. We're better than that. But the bills still do, and everyone pays up.
We can handle it.
Go see Ralphie about a car.
Okay, boss.
Now, Vinny said to say he's got something for you, Tom. Head to him first. Probably just wants to tell you some bullshit story about some guy he whacked 20 years ago.
Just the guy. I saw this, and I thought of you. You ever carried a rat?
Shot him at the fair a couple of times.
Right. That don't count. Pointed at the target over there.
Come on, we haven't got all day. Show me your aim.
Good pot, bang. Brain all up the walls. Okay, now show me a reload. I open the chamber and away you go. All right, last thing needs to be hidden. Stick it in your belt. Good to go. And when shooting starts, get behind something and don't shit yourself.
Thanks, Vincenzo. I appreciate it.
Hey, the Frank and the boss, Vincenzo. To you. It's Finny.
Not at me, you moron.
You know how to get into one of these, Tommy?
Elbow goes through, reach inside, easy.
And in the afternoon to fix the window back up. Watch. And learn.
You're a regular magician, Ralphie.
Tommy, show me what you can do. Okay, it's caught. You got it. Have a good day, fellas.
For First, we got Al. He runs a bakery on Longman Street. You know it?
Yeah, I know it.
Al's late again? Seems so. That's too bad. This is it. Watch what we do today, Tom. When it goes smooth, it's a breeze. When they put up a fight, sometimes you gotta think on your feet.
Sure.
Just follow my lead.
Sam, Polly, how are you?
We're good. How's little Julia?
Ha! Not so little now. She's turning into a pain in the ass, just like her grandma.
That's good to hear, Al. Real good. Now, you got any trouble around here? Any punks causing problems?
No, no. Nothing like that.
Good. So you got the money?
I got it waiting in the back room.
Tommy will get it. You stay here where we can see you.
It's been real slow this month, Sam. I was worried I wouldn't have enough.
Al, I know you'd never hold out on us, but it's good you worry. I mean, how can we protect you and little Julia without payment?
You gonna take all day, Tommy? We got places we need to be.
Where's the money?
Terron, fecha! Voi ci succhiate il sangue!
It's on the table, brown envelope!
Via di qui! Lasciateci in pace!
I got it.
See you next month, Al. Let us know if you need anything. Anything at all.
Sure will, Sam. Sure will.
And give our best to your mom, huh?
Okay, next up, we got old Eugene's place. Chinese store up on Tallow.
He's not dead yet?
Almost. Heard his nephew's taking over.
Guy used to run this next place, Tom? His name's not Eugene. Guy's a Chinaman. But it sounds like Eugene. Well, that's what we called him.
Polly slammed his head into the counter back in, what, 27, I think?
Yeah, it was hilarious. After that, no problems at all.
If you look, you can still see the blood. Poor old bastard couldn't scrub it out. We keep some of these guys on our books to remind the Chinatown gangs they're in our city, not theirs. But we don't know Eugene's nephew, so he might need reminding too.
Thank you.
this is it. I'll cover this one, Sam.
You sure?
Sure, I'm sure.
He's doing the store on his own?
Yeah, when Polly's built up a little steam, he needs to let it out on his own. She gotta let him get on with it. It's his way. You can hear it in his voice. Gotta let him lone wolf from time to time. Keeps him happy. Yeah, Eugene's nephew ain't having much fun right now. When he's going, Polly don't stop. Once we were putting a squeeze on this tailor over in Holbrook, guy ended up in a wheelchair.
Hey, elbow guy, drop it.
Here he comes.
He's a fast worker.
Drive before the cop show, Tom. Next stop's Bill at the motel. Eugene's nephew's guy's money is ours next week, with some extra besides.
He doing okay?
He's okay.
How's the shop counter?
Yeah, that's seen some more blood.
How much blood?
And nothing he can't scrub out. Once he's back on his feet.
Wanna come out with us again, Tom? Get to hear even more about Chinese nephew guys scrubbing their own blood out of shop counters.
Yeah, seems like it's not too hard.
Not hard? What kind of not hard?
I don't know. Comes natural to you guys. Don't see why it can't come natural to me.
So anyone could do this. Me and Polly, we've been working these streets for years. You come in and you think you know it all?
I'm not saying that, Sam.
You've been a day on the job, pal. You haven't seen what we do. You haven't seen how we do it. Sam, I think you oughta... No, Polly. This punk thinks he can walk in here like a big shot. I put greasers like him in the ground.
I think you gotta say you're sorry, Tom.
Sorry, huh? Well, I'd say sorry if I couldn't see the bullshit smile you're trying to hide.
You got him, though, Sam! You got him!
I could smell the crap in your pants from here.
Nah, you didn't get me.
When little Tony first came out with us, I had him on his knees before he knew I was yanking his chain.
Yeah, you did better than him anyways.
Jesus, I hate it out of the city.
You hate it most places.
Yeah, but out here it's worse.
How come there's a place so far out of town on our books?
Out of town's the safest place for deals. Safest place for card games. The safest place for most of the things we do.
We're expecting a big bag of money today. The guy owes. If it ain't big, the boss will be pissed.
Yeah, this place is a real earner. Oftentimes, the places that get you the most dough are the ones most people don't look at twice.
Just recently, the motel's had a new lease of life.
Last stop before Lost Heaven for rum coming up from Cuba.
They drive it this far?
Sure they do. And that's how we can sell it so expensive.
Bill's motel has gotten to be the place where crates get exchanged. Salieri protects it, but he lets the other families use it too.
Even Morello?
To keep the peace? Sure.
Plus, it's far enough away that no one cares.
So long as everyone's making money, no one's gonna rock the boat.
Anyone else starting to miss the sight of streets and sidewalks?
You not one for the great outdoors, Polly?
He's not one for anything. Indoors, outdoors, in the city, out of the city.
I hate it out here. Like when we sit in the field doing some booze handover or something. It's always knee-deep in shit, and most times it's dark and cold as hell.
That's why it's good we got you now, Tom. You can do all the jobs that Polly hates.
But happy to oblige.
Okay, there it is.
Finally! Wait for us here, Tom. We'll be back in a bit.
Okay.
I took one. Jesus Christ, Polly!
Tell Salieri from here on out this place is ours. Capisce? And don't come back, or you'll end up in worse shape than your friends.
Get Sam. They're trying to beat information out of him.
I gotta get you to a doctor.
I can wait. Get Sam out of there.
Okay, just hang on.
Get over here now!
Rough night last night?
Your car's still outside.
I know.
I see him!
I think we just rub them all out.
Making you pay!
No place to run!
me some... Shit!
Sam, oh, they really went to work on you, buddy.
Christ!
Come on, you'll be all right. You're tough as nails! Oh, shit!
He's got the money, Tom!
I'll catch the bastard! He's okay. Inside.
Then go get the money!
That was when I saw the cost. What it meant to be on the inside. Huh. I should have took off there and then. But I couldn't go back to being a nobody.
So that's how a regular palooka goes from cabbie to mob enforcer overnight, is it? Just dumb luck?
Didn't feel that way at the time. Me parking on that particular street, taking a break just when Polly and Sam are coming around the corner, what are the odds? I felt like, I don't know, like someone was watching out for us.
Whatever helps you sleep at night, pal, but it's a lucky break all the same. I mean, one day you're busting your back, doing an honest day's work in a city that's been trying to scrape you off its heels since the day you stepped off the boat, and the next you're stuffing your pockets full of Salieri's dirty money and lording it over the rest of us.
Yeah, it wasn't like that. Back then, Salieri didn't have the run of the city. For every buck Salieri made, Don Morello would turn 10. He paid off cops, politicians, judges, and anyone he couldn't buy, he scared into looking the other way.
He did seem to have the city jumping in its own shadow, I'll give you that.
You hear anything about Joey Crackers?
Yeah, got his name in the Morello file, sure. Boxer, right?
Yeah. That's the guy. Way I hear it, Joey was just driving to the gym one morning. Probably daydreaming about winning a belt or something.
God damn it! Moron! You're driving with your goddamn eyes closed! Look at this!
Jesus, Mary, Joseph, Tom Morello, I didn't know it was you.
You know anybody else driving a rare import in this part of town, Joey?
No. Well, then, I'm sorry, I was driving real slow.
You're saying this is my fault?
No, sir. I ain't never been in no accident.
Well, repairs are gonna be expensive.
Oh, you're not gonna need that, sir. The tires are just fine. The grill's a little bent up, is all. I mean, I got a cousin,
Someone spun you a tail, pal. You got an informant right there, says Morello made a mint every time Crackers went to the mat.
That's true, too. And still, Morello left that poor sap dead in the street. Head all caved in.
That don't square.
Well, maybe the Don knew Joey's career was on the downhill. Or maybe he was trying to scare some other guy into paying up. Who knows? Don Salieri chalked it up to Morello not being able to think straight when he was mad.
You have any more run-ins with Morello's crew back then?
Not at first. For a couple of years after I joined up, things were quiet. We got into a few dust-ups with guys trying to muscle in, but elsewise it was just the usual routine. We were running booze, offering protection, me and the boys doing rounds to collect, small time. But I ain't gonna lie. Most days, we was also having a bit of fun.